There's a bright golden haze on the meadow. There's a bright golden haze on the meadow. The corn is as high as an elephant's eye, and it looks like it's climbing clear up to the sky. Oh, what a beautiful morning. Oh, what a beautiful day. I got a beautiful feeling. Everything's going my way. All the cattle are standing like statues. All the cattle are standing like statues. They don't turn their heads as they see me ride by. But a little brown maverick is winking her eye. Oh, what a beautiful morning. Oh, what a beautiful day. I got a beautiful All the sounds of the earth are like music. All the sounds of the earth are like music. The breeze is so busy, don't miss a tree. But an old weeping willer is laughing at me. Oh, what a beautiful morning.
You weren't so young and smart, Alecky. Well, I'd marry you and so you could sit around at night and sing to me.
Well, no, you wouldn't either. So I wouldn't marry you near none of your kinfolk, I could help it.
Oh, none of my kinfolk, huh?
And you can tell them that, too. All of them, including that niece of yours, Miss Laurie Williams. Well, Aunt Eller, if you was to tell me where Laurie was at, where would you say she was at?
Well, I wouldn't tell you. As far as I can tell, she ain't paying you no heed.
She don't take to me much, huh?
No.
Where'd you get such an uppity niece at anyways, wouldn't pay no heed to me? Well, who's the best bronc buster in this year territory?
Well, you, I guess.
And the best bulldogger in 17 counties? Well, me, that's who. And look at here. Well, I'm handsome, ain't I?
Curly as a pitcher.
Curly-headed, ain't I? Bow-legged from the saddle for God knows how long, ain't I?
Couldn't stop a pig in the road.
Well, what else does she want then, the damn she-mule?
Well, I don't know, but I'm sure it ain't you. Who are you taking to the box social tonight?
I ain't thought much about it.
I'll bet you come over to ask Laurie.
What if I did?
Can I come, too? I'll wear my fascinator.
Yeah, you too.
Oh, what a beautiful morning. Oh, what a beautiful day. Well, I thought you were somebody. I got a beautiful feeling. Saturday morning.
Well, you knowed it was me before you opened the door.
No such of a thing.
Did too? Well, you hear my voice and knowed it was me.
Well, I heard a voice talking rumbling along with Aunt Eller, and heard someone singing like a bullfrog in a pond.
You knowed it was me, so you sat up there thinking of something mean to say to me. Well, I'm a good mind not to ask you to the box social.
Well, if you did ask me, it wouldn't go with you. buy a new buggy with red wheels onto it, have you?
No, I ain't.
And a spanking team with their bridles all jingling?
No.
Expect me to ride on behind old Dunn, I guess. You better ask that old Cummins girl you took such a shine to over across the river.
I was to ask you, would that be a way to take you, Miss Laurie Smarty?
Oh, they would.
When I take you out tonight with me, honey, here's the way it's gonna be. We'll sit behind a team of snow white horses in the slickest gig you ever seen. Chicks and ducks and geese better scurry when I take you out in the Surrey. When I take you out in the Surrey with the fringe on top. Watch that fringe and see how it flows. When I drive them high-stepping strutters, nosy folks peek through their shutters and their eyes will pop. The wheels are yeller, the upholstery is brown, the dashboard's genuine leather. With eyes and glass curtains, you can roll right down in case there's a change in the weather. Two bright side lights winking and blinking. Ain't no finer rig, I'm thinking. Well, you can keep your rig if you're thinking. And I gear to swap for that shiny little Surrey with the fringe on the top.
What to say, the fringe was made of silk.
Would have no other kind but silk.
Hasn't really got a team of snow-wise horses.
One's like snow. The other's more like milk,
so you can tell them apart.
All the world will fly in a flurry when I take you out in the Surrey. When I take you out in the Surrey with the fringe on top. When we hit that row hell for leather, cats and dogs will dance in the heather. Birds and frogs will sing all together, and the toads will hop. The wind will whistle as we rattle along. The cows will moo in the clover. The river will ripple out a whispered song and whisper it over and over. Don't you wish you'd go on forever? Don't you wish you'd go on forever? Don't you wish you'd go on forever? And it never stopped in that shiny little Surrey with the fringe on the top.
My, you'd sure feel like a queen sitting up on top of that carriage.
Only, she talked to me so mean a while back, Eleanor. I'm a good mind not to take
her. Ain't said I was going.
Well, I ain't ask you.
But where'd you get such a rig at anyway? Oh, I bet he's went high to rig over to Claremore, thinking I'd go with him.
That's all you know about it.
Spent all his money high to rig, and now I ain't got nobody to ride in it.
I have two. What? Well, did not hire it. Made the whole thing up.
What? Made it up!
Dashboard and all!
Oh, get off the place, you! Hey. Eller, get us up out of here! Tell me lies!
Hey, I'm making up a few. Well, look out now! Making up a few birdies ain't a good no law that I know of. Don't you wish they was such a rig, though? Go to a play party? To a hoedown till morning if you was in mind to. And then when you was all wore out, I'd lift you up onto the Surrey and jump up alongside you. Want the horses home. I can just picture the whole thing. I can see the stars getting blurry when we ride back home in the Surrey. Riding slowly home in the Surrey with the fringe on top. I can feel the day getting older. Feel a sleepy head near my shoulder, nodding, drooping close to my shoulder till it falls. Kerplop, the sun is swimming on the river that hill. The moon is taking a header, and just as I'm thinking, all the earth is still. I'll wake up in the meadow. My baby's sleeping. Maybe got a dream worth a keeping. Whoa, you team, and just keep a creeping and a
slug. Clip, clop. Don't you hurry with the silly with the fringe on the top.
Only there ain't no such rig. You just said you made the whole thing up.
Well,
why'd you come around here with your stories and lies get me all worked up that way? Talking about the sun swimming on the hill and all the lights were so. Why, who would have wrong lights thought of you anyway?
Why'd you just grab her and kiss her when she acts like that, Curly? She's just aching for you too, I bet.
Oh, I didn't even speak to him, let alone allow him to kiss me. The bragging, bow-legged, wish he had a sweetheart bum.
She likes you a lot.
She liked me anymore, she'd sick the dogs on to me.
Get the wagon hitched up?
What wagon?
These are a crowd of folks coming down from Bushy Head for the box social.
Curly said maybe you'd loan us your big wagon so we could bring them up from the station.
Well, I would if he asked me.
I've got to talk about a lot of other things. Well, I'll go hitch up the horses now and say it's all right.
That's fine.
Howdy, I come to Ellers, look what we brought
us. Hey, Will!
Hey, Ellers!
Hey! What happened at the fair? How'd you do with the steer roping?
Well, I did pretty good. I won it.
Good boy.
I always knew you would.
I always said us territory boys did good with the rope.
Well, I can't stay but a minute, Ann Eller. Well, don't you remember? Aunt Annie's pa promised I could marry her if I ever got $50.
$50? Is that what you won for the prize?
That's what.
What? I hope he keeps his word. If so, we'll be dancing at your wedding.
And if he don't, I'll take her from right underneath his nose. I won't even give him the present I got for him.
Felt. Here's the present.
What's that?
Look what I got for Aunt Annie's pa. Excuse us, Aunt Eller. Okay, you stick this up your eye, and when you get a good look, you turn it around at the top, and the picture changes.
Look.
Oh, well, I'll be side gated.
You
call it the little
you
wonder.
Silly goat. She ought to be ashamed of herself, and so should you. Oh, wait a minute. How do you fix it so you can see the picture at the other end?
It's right up here.
Oh. I'm a good boy to tell Annie on you.
Oh, please don't, Ann Eller. She wouldn't understand.
Well, what did you do in Kansas City? Bet you did all sorts of carrying on.
Oh, I wouldn't exactly call it carrying on, but I sure did see some things never to see before. I got to Kansas City on a Friday. On Saturday, I learned a thing or two. For up to then, I didn't have an idea of what the modern world was coming to. Like counting 20 gas buggies going by themselves. Almost every time I took a walk. And I put my ear to a bell telephone, and a strange woman started in to talk.
What next?
Now what?
Boy, next. Everything up to date in Kansas City. They gone about as far as they can go. They went and built a skyscraper 7 stories high. About as high as a building ought to grow. Everything like a dream in Kansas City. Every kind of comfort, every house is all complete. You can walk the privies in the rain, never wipe your feet. They gone about as far as they can go.
Yes, sir! They gone about as far as they can go.
Everything's up to date in Kansas City. They gone about as far as they can go. They got a big theater, they call the Pearly Q. For 50 cents you can see a dandy show.
Girls!
One of the gals, fat and pink and pretty. Round above as she is round below. I swear that she was padded from her shoulders to her heels. Later in the second, she began to feel that everything she had was absolutely real.
She went about as far as she could go.
Yes, sir! She went about as far as she could go.
What's she doing?
Go, two-stick! That's all we're doing nowadays.
But
The waltz is through. Get John? A one and a two. A one and a two. Of course they don't do long. Come on, Aeon.
Today. Leaving it till tomorrow. I got to quit early because I'm driving Lori to the party.
Well, you're driving Lori?
Master.
Wouldn't that just make you bald? Well, don't forget, Aunt Eller. You and me's got a date together. Make up a nice box of lunch, well, maybe I'll bid for it.
How are we going? In that made up rig of yours? I'll sit astraddle of them lights like the glowing white lightning bugs.
There ain't no made-up ring. I hired it down to Claremore.
Man, she did?
Sure did. Brilliant, too. Now, when I come calling for you right after supper, you see you got your beauty spot fast, and I'll probably say it won't fall off, you hear? That's a right smart turnout, that is.
The wheels are yeller, the upholstery is brown, the dashboard's genuine leather. With eyes and glass curtains, you can roll right down. In case there's a change in the weather.
See you before tonight, anyways. Way back from the station.
Ain't no finer rig if you're thinking of here to swap for that shiny little Surrey with the fringe on the top.
Oh, Curly, when you stop by, the girls and Bushy, yeah, tell them to stop by and freshen up. It's a long way to Skidmore. We're going to have company for lunch. You better pack up that picnic camper, Jordan.
Aunt Eller, don't won't go to Skidmore's with Curly tonight. Well, if you do, I'll have to ride with John all alone.
Well, that's what you want, ain't it?
No, I did it because Curly was so fresh. But I'm afraid to tell John I won't go with him, Aunt Ellen. I'm afraid he'd do something terrible. Ever go down the old smokehouse where he's at?
Plenty of times. Why?
Ever seen his pictures got tacked onto the walls?
Oh, yeah, but you don't need to pay no attention to them.
Something wrong inside of me, Aunt Eller. I hook my door at night and fasten my windows again. Again it. And the sound of feet walking up and down under that tree outside my room.
Laurie.
In the morning he comes for his breakfast and looks at me from under his eyebrows like something in the brush somewheres. I know what I'm talking about.
Oh, now, just don't you carry on like a chicken with his head cut off. Who's that that just broke up?
Oh, they look up for Bertie.
Well, it's that old peddler man. You know, the one that sold me that egg beater. Well,
he's got 80 Annie with him. Will Parker's 80 Annie.
That old peddler, he told me that egg beater would feed eggs and wring out a dish rag and turn an ice cream freezer and I don't know what all.
Yoo-hoo! 80 Annie!
Hold your horses, peddler man. I want to talk to you.
Hi, Aunt Eller.
Hey there.
Hello, Lori.
Hello. Will Parker's back from Kansas City. He's looking for you.
Will Parker? Well, I didn't count on him being back so soon.
Well, I can see that. Been riding a piece.
The peddler man's gonna drive me to the box social. I get up sort of a tasty lunch.
Ado, Annie, have you tucked up with that peddler man?
Not yet.
But you promised to Will Parker, ain't ya?
Well, not what you might say promise. I just told him maybe.
Well, don't you like him no more?
Of course I do. There won't never be nobody like Will.
What about this peddler man?
Well, there won't never be nobody like him, neither.
Well, which one do you like the best?
Whatever one I work.
You air silly.
Now, Lori, you know they didn't nobody pay me no mind up in this year. Kind of I was crying and flat as a beanpole. Then I kind of rounded up a little, and now the boys act different to me.
Well, what's wrong with that?
Nothing's wrong. I like it. I like it so much when a feller talks pretty to me, I get all shaky from horn to hoof. Don't you?
Can't think what you're talking about.
What, don't you feel kind of sorry for a feller when he looks like he wants to kiss you?
You just can't go around kissing every man that asks you. Didn't anybody ever tell you that?
Yeah, they told me. It ain't so much a question of not knowing what to do. I know what's right and wrong since I've been 10. I hear a lot of stories and I reckon they are true. About how girls are put in love by men. I know I mustn't fall into the pit, but when I'm with a feller, I forget! I'm just a girl who can't say no. I'm in a terrible fix. I always say, come on, let's go. Just when I ought to stay next. When a person tries to kiss a girl, I know she ought to give his face a smack. But as soon as someone kisses me, I somehow sort of want to kiss them back. I'm just a fool with eyes they're low. I can't be prissy and quick. I ain't the type that can spin. How can I be what I did? I didn't say no. What you gonna do when a feller gets flirty and starts to talk pretty? What you gonna do? Supposing that he says that your lips are like cherries or roses or berries. What you gonna do? Supposing that he says that you're sweeter and cream and he's gotta have cream or die. What you gonna do when he talks that way? Spit in his eye? I'm just a girl who can't say no. Can't seem to say it at all. I hate to disappoint the folks when he is paying the call.
man, no matter what.
It's an egg beater.
I sure am sorry for Farley Hackham, though.
You do not know how to use the egg beater.
Farley Hackham? That's his name?
Yeah!
Curzon!
You sure were starting to love him better than you love Will?
Well, I
was sure. And now that old Will has to come home, and first thing you know, he'll start talking purty to me and changing my mind back.
But Will wants to marry you.
So does Allie Hackham.
Well, did he ask you?
Well, not directly. But how I know is, he said this morning when he was riding in his buggy, that he wanted for me to drive like that with him to the end of the world. Well, if we only got as far as Catoosie, that'd take the sun down, wouldn't it? And then we'd have to go somewhere else and be all night together. And being together all night means he wants a wedding. Don't it?
That's what Hillary don't.
All right. If the egg beater don't work, I get you something just as good.
Just as good? It better be 1,000,000,000 times better.
Oh my, Miss Laurie. Jippity crickets, how high you've grown up. Well, last time I come through here, you was tiny like a shrimp with freckles. And now look at you, a great, big, beautiful lady.
Oh, quit biting me. If you ain't had no breakfast, go eat yourself a green apple.
Now, Aunt Eller, just
I
listen.
I ain't your Aunt Eller. Don't you call me Aunt Eller, you little wart. I'm mad at you.
All right. Don't go and be mad at me. Ain't I said I'd get you a present? Let me see here. Something to wear.
Oh, but don't need nothing to wear. Wouldn't wear it anyway.
What is it?
Real silk, made in Persia.
What I want with an old Persian garment?
Oh, they look awful pretty, eh, Eller? With bows on to them and all?
Well, I'll try it.
Hold out your foot.
Now, where did you get the idea I was going to let you put your hands up my limb? Here, help me, Glory.
Funny woman. Would be much worse if I tried to take her garters off.
Yeah, because that would make her stockings fall down, wouldn't it?
Let me see the other one.
You want to buy this one to match?
Buy it?
Yes, I can let you have it for 4 bits, 50 cents.
Do you want me to take that egg beater and ram it down your windpipe?
All right. Well, don't anybody want to buy something? How about you, Miss Laurie? You must be wanting something, a pretty young girl like you.
Me? Well, of course I want something. Yeah. I want a buckle made out of shiny silver to fasten onto my shoes. I want a dress with lace. I want perfume. Want to be pretty. Want to smell like a honeysuckle vine.
Fire a cake of soap.
Want things I've heard of and never had before. A rubber-tired buggy. A cut-glass sugar bowl. Want things I can't tell you about. Want things not only to look at and hold in your hand, but things to happen to you. Things so nice if they ever did happen to you, your heart would quit beating and you'd fall down dead.
I've got just a thing for you. The elixir of Egypt.
Well, what's that?
A special formula used by Pharaoh's daughter.
Smelling salts.
What a special kind of smelling salts. Read what it says on the label. Take a deep breath, and you will see everything clear. That's what Pharaoh's daughter used to do when she had a hard problem to decide, like what prince she ought to marry. Or what dress she ought to wear to a party, or whether she ought to cut off somebody's head. She just take a whiff of this?
I'll take a bottle of that, Mr. Peddler.
Oh, precious stuff.
How much?
2 bits.
Throwing your money away.
Oh. Well, it helps you decide what to do.
Now, don't anybody want to buy some fancy doodads with lace running around the top and ribbons running in and out, huh?
Fancy drawers?
All made in Paris.
Well, I don't wear them myself, but I like to look at them.
Yeah, they's all right, if you ain't going no place.
Well, gather all your stuff together and come on in. I'll get you something to eat or drink, maybe.
Go and ask them, don't you?
Allie?
Yes, baby.
Me and Lori've been having an argument.
About what, baby?
About what you meant when you said that about driving with me to the end of the world?
Well, I didn't exactly mean to the end of the world.
Then how far did you want to go?
Well, about as far as, say, Claremore to the hotel.
What's at the hotel?
In front of the hotel is a veranda. Inside the hotel, a lobby. Upstairs? Upstairs might be paradise.
I thought they was just bedrooms.
For you and me, baby, paradise.
You see? I knew I was right and Lori was wrong. Oh. You do want to marry me, don't you?
Oh, hey, Granny, what did you say?
I said you do want to marry me, don't you? What did you say?
I didn't say nothing.
Yahoo! I'm back.
Oh, Foot, just when... Hello, Will. That's Will Parker. Promise me you won't fight him.
Why fight? I hardly know the man. I only fight with my friends.
Ain't any. Now, how's my honey bunch? How's the sweetest little 110 pounds of sugar in the territory?
Will, this is
Dolly Atkins. How are you? Don't mind the way I talk. It's all right. I'm going to marry her.
Marry her? On purpose?
Well, sure.
No such of a thing.
Oh, marriage is a wonderful thing.
Allie?
I got a brother in Persia. He got six wives.
Six wives all at once?
Sure, that's the way they do it in them countries.
No, not always. I got another brother in Persia. He only got one wife. He's a bachelor.
Look, Will.
Look, Will, nothing. You know what I got for first prize at the fair? $50.
Well, that was good. $50?
Catch on? Your pa promised I could marry you if I ever got $50.
That's right, he did.
You know what I've done with it? Spent it all on presents for you.
But if you spend it, you ain't got the cash.
What I got's worth more than cash. The feller sold me the stuff, told me.
But Will.
But Will, nothing. When do I get a little old kiss? Oh, hey, Danny. You ain't been off my mind since I left. Why, even at the fair when I was chasing steer, I broke one under his hooves and I pulled him up sharp. He'd fall on his little rump, and then I think of you.
Don't start talking purdy, Will.
I've seen a lot of beautiful gals in Kansas City. Didn't give them one look.
How could you see them if you didn't give them a look?
Why, I didn't look loving at them the way I look at you.
Oh, Will, please don't look like that. I can't bear it.
I won't stop looking like this till I get a little old kiss.
Oh, what's a little old kiss?
Nothing unless it's coming from you.
You do talk purdy. No! No, I won't!
Supposing that I say that your lips are like cherries, or roses or berries, what you gonna do? Can't you feel my heart palpitating and a bumping, or waiting for something, something nice from you? I gotta get a kiss, and it's gotta be quick, or I'll jump in a creek and die.
Water the team.
Right away, Aunt Eller.
Can I come too, Curly? Just love to watch the way you handle horses.
That's about all I can handle, I guess.
I can't believe that. Not from what I hear about you.
Looks like Curly's took up with that Cummins girl.
What I care about that.
Come on, fellas. Let's take the picnic campers out under the trees to keep the food cool. Come on.
Why should a woman who is healthy and strong love her like a baby if her man goes away? Oh, that's one thing you'll never hear me say. Never gonna think that the man I lose is the only man among men. I'll snap my fingers.
Beautiful silk dresses.
Allie Cackle?
Oh, hello, Kido.
I'm sure sorry to see you so happy, because what I gotta say will make you miserable. I've gotta marry Will.
Oh, that is sad news for me. Well, he is a fine fellow.
But don't hide your feelings, Allie. I can't stand it. I'd rather have you come right out and say your heart is busted in two.
Are you positive you got to marry Will?
Sure shooting.
And there's no chance for you to change your mind?
No chance.
All right, then. My heart is busted in two.
Oh, Allie, you do make a pretty thing to say.
That you, Annie?
Hello, Paul. What's he been shooting?
Rabbits. That true what I hear about Will Parker getting $50?
That's right, Paul. And he wants to hold you to your promise.
Too bad. Still and all, I can't go back on my word.
See Allie Hackham?
I'd advise you to get that money off of him before he loses it. Put it in your stocking or your corset where he can't get at it. Or can he?
But Paul, he ain't exactly kept it. He spent it all on presents.
See what I tell you. Now he can't have you. I said it had to be $50 cash.
But Mr. Carnes, is that fair?
Who the hell are you?
This is Allie Hackham.
Well, shut your face, or I'm going to fill your behind with so much buckshot, you'll be walking like a duck the rest of your life.
Allie, if I don't have to marry Will, maybe your heart won't be busted in two, like you said.
I did not say that.
Oh, yes, you did.
No, I did not.
You making out my daughter to be a liar?
No, I'm only making it perfectly clear what a liar I am if she's telling the truth.
What else you been saying to my daughter?
Oh, an awful lot.
When?
Last night in the moonlight.
Where?
Alongside a haystack.
Listen, Mr. Carnes.
I'm listening. What else did you say?
He called me his Persian kitten.
Why'd you call her that?
I don't remember.
I do. He said it was like a Persian kitten because they were the cats with the soft brown tails.
That's enough. This part of the country, that better be a proposal of marriage.
That's what I thought.
Look. Is that what you think?
Look, Mr. Carnes.
I'm looking.
I'm no good. I'm a peddler. A peddler travels up and down and all around and, Well, you'd hardly ever see your daughter no more.
That'd be okay. Take care of her, son. Take care of my little Rosebud.
Oh, Paul, that's pretty. You sure for starting you can bear to let me go, Paul?
Are you sure, Mr. Carnes?
Just try and change my mind, see what happens to you.
Oh, Allie Hackum, ain't it wonderful? Paul making up her mind for us? He won't change, neither. Once he gives his word that you can have me, why, you've got me.
I know. I've got you.
Mrs. Allie Hackum, the peddler's bride. Wait till I tell the girls.
Trapped. Tricked. Hoodblinked. Ambushed.
Put on your mind, why do you walk around and around? Take your hands, put it behind, take your chins, take the ground.
20 minutes ago, I'm free like a breeze, free like a bird in the woodland wild, free like a gypsy, free like a child. I'm unattached. 20 minutes ago, I can do what I please. Flick a cigar ash on a rug. Dunk with a donut. Drink from a jug. I'm a happy man. I'm minding my own business like I oughter. Ain't meaning any harm to anyone. I'm talking to a certain farmer's daughter. Then I'm looking down the muzzle of a gun.
You get it so you can have any fun. Every daughter has a father with a gun. It's a scandal, it's an outrage, how a gal gets a husband today.
If you make one mistake when the moon is bright, then they tie you to a contract so you make it every night.
It's a scandal, it's an outrage, when her family surround you and say, you gotta take and make an honest woman out of hell.
To make you make her honest, she will lie like hell.
It's a scandal, it's an outrage, on our manhood it's a butt. Where is leader will save us and be the first man to be shot.
Me?
Yes, you! It's a scandal.
By heck, there's a baby on your shoulder making bubbles on your neck.
It's a scandal, it's an outrage. Any farmer will tell you it's true.
The rooster in the chicken coop is better off than men. He ain't the special property of just one hen.
It's a scandal, it's an outrage. It's a problem we must solve.
Just yet.
Well, don't be too long. And don't forget, tonight at the auction, mine's the biggest. That little Cummins girl I hear so much talk of.
Well, you've seen her before, ain't you?
Yeah, but not since she got so old. She never did see anybody get so peacock looking in such a short time.
She says she's 18. I believe that she's already 19.
What you got in your hamper?
Just some old meat pies and apple jelly. Nothing like what Gertie Cummins has in her basket.
You really going to the box social tonight with that Judd feller?
Reckon so. Why?
Well, nothing. It's just that everybody seems to expect me to take you.
Then maybe it's just well you ain't. We don't want people talking about us, do we?
Well, you think they do talk about us?
Oh, you know how they air. Like a swarm of mud wasps. Always gotta be buzzing about something.
What they say? That you're stuck on me?
Most of the talk is that you're stuck on me.
Well, I can't imagine how ugly rumors like that would start.
Well, me neither. Why do they think of stories that link my name with yours?
Why do the neighbors gossip all day behind their doors?
I know a way to prove what they say is quite untrue. Here is the gist of the reticle list of don'ts for you.
Feller, you'd rather go with me tonight.
Curly, I couldn't.
Well, you couldn't. I think I'm going up here to Smokehouse where Judd's at. See what's so elegant about him. Makes women want to go to parties with him.
But Curly.
What?
Spot on your cheek, just under your eye.
Open it, can't you?
Well, howdy.
What do you want?
Done got through all my business up here at the house. I just thought I'd pay you a visit. You got a gun, I see.
Good. .45.
Well, what'd you do with it?
Shoot things.
Oh. That there pink picture, why, that's a naked woman, ain't it?
Your eyes don't lie to you.
I'm stark naked as a jaybird. Why? Well, no. No, not quite. She got a couple of them thingamabobs tied onto her.
Shucks, you think that's something? Look here, this topper.
Whoa! I go blind. Why? That'd give me IDs, that would.
That's a dinger, that is.
Sure is a dinger. That's a good looking rope you got there. It's been nice. But you know that, Will Parker. Sure, spin a rope. That's a strong beam you got there. Well, you could hang yourself from that gut.
I could what?
Well, hang yourself. It'd be as easy as falling off a log. But the fact is, you could stand on a log. Or a chair. Right about here, see? You put this here around your neck. Well, tie that good up there first, of course. Then all you have to do would be fall off the log, or the chair, whichever you'd rather fall off of. 5 minutes or less of good luck, you'd be as dead as a doornail.
What do you mean by that?
And folks that come to your funeral sing sad songs.
Nah.
They would. Why, you never know how many folks like you till you're dead. Probably be laid out in the parlor, docked out in your best suit with your hair combed back slick in a high starched collar.
They'd be flowers, you think?
Sure would. Palms, too, all around your coffin. Folks would gather from all around. Men would bare their heads. Women would sniffle softly. Some would probably faint. Ones that took a shining to you while you were still alive.
A woman took a shine to me.
Well, that's a woman. Only they don't ever come right out and show you how they feel less than you die first.
Guess that's so.
Sure would sing wild though when the singing started. Like their hearts would break.
Poor Judd is dead, poor Judd Fry is dead. All gather round his coffin now and cry. He wasn't very old, but he had a heart of gold. Oh, why did such a feller have to die? Poor Judd is dead, poor Judd Fry's dead. He's looking oh so peaceful and serene.
And serene.
He's all laid out to rest with his hands across his chest. His fingernails have never been so clean.
And the preacher get up. Say, folks, we're gathered here today to moan and groan over our brother Judd Fry, who hung himself up by a rope in the smokehouse. And there'd be weeping and wailing from some of them women. And he'd say, Judd was the most misunderstood man in the territory. Well, people used to think he was a mean, ugly feller, and they called him a dirty skunk-killing, ornery pig stealer.
But the folks had really known him. Knowed beneath them two dirty shirts he always wore. Their feet are hard as big as all outdoors.
As big as all outdoors.
Judd Fry loved his fellow man.
He loved his fellow man.
He loved mice and vermin. And he treated the rats like equals, which was right. He loved little children. Oh, he loved everybody and everything in the world, only he never let on. So nobody ever noticed. Poor Judd is dead. Poor Judd Fry is dead. His friends weep and wail for miles around.
Miles around.
The daisies in the dell will give out a different smell, because poor Judd is underneath the ground.
Poor Judd is dead, a candle lights his head. He's laying in a coffin made of wood.
Wood.
And folks are feeling sad, 'cause they used to treat him bad, and now they know their friend is gone for good.
Good.
Poor Judd is dead. A candle lights his head.
He's looking oh so pretty and so nice. He looks like he's asleep. It's a shame that he won't keep, but it's summer and we're running out of ice. Poor Judd, poor Judd. Yes, sir, that's the way to be. Sure be an interesting funeral. Wouldn't like to miss it.
Would like to miss it, eh? Maybe you will. Maybe you go first.
Maybe. Let's see, where'd you work at before you come here? It was up by Quapaw, wasn't it?
Yes, before that over by Tulsa. Lousy they was for me, both of them. Always making out they better. Treating me like dirt.
Well, what'd you do? Get even?
Say anything about getting even?
Well, no one that I recollect. It just come into my head.
Yeah, but if it ever come to getting even, I'd know how to do it.
With that?
That. They safe ways than that, if you use your brain. Remember that farm, Barnum Farm over by Sweetwater?
Sure do. That was about 5 years ago. Burnt up the father, mother, and the daughter. Terrible accident.
Weren't no accident. Feller told me. The hired hand was stuck on the Bartlett girl, and he caught her in the hayloft with another feller.
And it was him that burnt the place?
Took him weeks, buying all the kerosene at different times. Feller told me made out like it happened in Missouri, but I know it all the time it was at Bartlett Farm. What a liar he was.
And a kind of, well, kind of a murderer too, wasn't he? Get some air in here.
You ain't told me yet what business you had here. We got no cattle to sell, no cow ponies, and the old crops done spoke for.
Sure relieved my mind considerable.
There's only one other thing on this farm you could want. And it better not be that!
Well, that's just what it is.
It better not be. Stay away from me, you hear?
You know, somebody ought to tell Laura what kind of man you are. For that matter, somebody ought to tell you once about yourself.
Better get out of here, Curly.
Thought I wouldn't feel very safe in here. I didn't know you. But I know you, Judd. There's two things you can do in this country if you're a man. One is live out of doors. The other's live in a hole. Well, I've sat by my horse in a bunch of mares, heard a rattlesnake many a time. Go scared to death. Somebody coming close to his hole. Somebody gonna step on him. Get his fangs ready, all full of poison. Curl up, wait. As long as you live in a hole, you're scared. You got to have protection. You can have muscles, like iron, still be weak as an empty bladder unless you got something to barb your hide with. Well, how'd you get to be the way you were anyway, sitting in this filthy stinkhole? Why don't you get out and do something healthier for once instead of saying shut up in here, a crawling and a festering? Gah! You ought to feel better. Hard on the roof. himself. She let me show you something. See that knot hole over there? About the size of a dime. I just want to see if I can hit it. Bullet right through the middle, without stitching, slick as a whistle. I know what I could do when you saw me too, didn't you? Well, I expect someone's a-coming.
Who fired a gun? Now don't you just stand there like a lonely speak when you're spoke to.
Well, I shout once.
What you shooting at?
See that knot hole over there?
I see a lot of knot holes.
Well, it was one of them.
Ain't you just a pair of nothing sitting here drank shot that silly old knot hole? I got mind to give you a good Dutch rub and harden some of that craziness out of you. It's all right, nobody's hurt. There was just trading noise. There's a pair of fools here.
Mind if I visit with you, gents? It's good to get away from the women for a while. And now then, we're all by ourselves. I got a few purdies, private knickknacks for to show you, special for the menfolk.
Excuse me, gentlemen, I gotta pick up a Surrey I hired for tonight.
Art postcard.
Who you think you're taking in that Surrey?
Well, Ann Eller. Laura, if she'll go with me.
She won't.
Maybe she will.
She promised she'd go with me, and she better not change her mind. She better not!
I want to show you these all straight from Paris.
I don't want none. Sick of them things. Any frog stickers?
You mean one of them long knives? What would you want with a thing like that?
I don't know. Kill a hog. Or a skunk. It's all the same, ain't it? Tell you what I'd really like if you got one. You ever seen one of them things called the Little Wonder? You see, it's something you hold up to your eye to see pictures. Only that ain't all there is to it. Not quite. It's got a little jigger onto it. And you touch it, and out springs a sharp blade.
On a spring, eh?
You say to a feller, look it through here. Then when he's looking, you snap out the blade. It's just above his chest, you see him, bang! Down he comes.
Well, a good joke to play on a friend, but I don't handle things like that. Too dangerous. What I'd like to show you is my new stock of postcards.
Don't want none. Sick of them things. Go on and get me a real woman.
Now, what do you want with a woman? Why, I'm having trouble right now, all on account of a woman. They always make trouble. And you say you want one? Why? Look at you! You're a man one is free to come and go as you please. You've got a nice cozy little place. Private. Nobody to bother you. Artistic pictures, they don't talk
about. Tired all these pictures of women!
All right. So throw them away and buy some new ones, huh? You get tired of a woman and what can you do? Nothing! You just keep getting tireder and tireder, huh?
Made up my mind.
So you want a real woman. Say, do you happen to know a girl named Adu Annie?
I don't want her.
I don't want her either. But I've got her.
No peddler. I want real things. What am I doing? Shut up here like that feller says, crawling and festering. What am I doing in this lousy smokehouse? The floor creaks, the door squeaks, there's a field mouse nibbling on the broom. And I sat by myself like a cobweb on a shelf, by myself in a lonely room. But when there's a moon in my window, and it slants down a beam across my bed, and the shatter of a tree starts dancing on the wall, and a dream starts dancing in my head, and all the things that I wish for turn out like I want them to be, and I'm better than that smart aleck cowhand who thinks he is better than me. And the girl that I want ain't afraid of my arms, and her own soft arms keep me warm. And her long yellow hair falls across my face, just like the rain in a storm. The floor creaks, the door squeaks, and the mouth cow starts nibbling on the broom, and the sun flicks my eyes. It was all a pack of lies! I'm awake in a lonely room. I ain't gonna dream about her arms no more. I ain't gonna leave her alone. Going outside, get myself a bride. Get me a woman to call my own.
Thank you. farmer and the cowman should be friends. Oh, the farmer and the cowman should be friends. One man likes to push a plow, the other likes to chase a cow. But that's no reason why they can't be friends. Territory folks should stick together, territory folks should all be pals. Cowboys dance with the farmer's daughters, farmers dance with the rancher's gals.
Territory folks should stick together, territory folks should all be pals. Cowboys dance with the farmer's daughters, farmers dance with the rancher's gals.
I'd like to say a word for the farmer.
Well, hey!
He's come out west and made a lot of changes.
Yes, sir.
It built them right across our cattle ranges.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. I intend the dirt scratchers going back to Missouri where they belong.
Oh, yeah. 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 Yeah.
Yeah. Never shut up. The farmer is a good and thrifty citizen.
He's thrifty, all right.
No matter what the cowman says or thinks. You'll never see him drinking in a bar room.
Unless somebody else is buying
three. Cowmen should be friends. Oh, the farmer and the cowman should be friends. The cowman ropes the cow with ease. The farmer steals her butter and cheese. But that's no reason why they can't be friends.
Thank you.
To meet up with you. It seems like you and me ought to have a little talk.
We only got one thing to talk about. Well, Mr. Hackham, I hear you got yourself engaged to Ada Annie.
Well,
nothing. I don't know what to call you. You ain't pretty enough for a skunk. You ain't skinny enough for a snake. Too little to be a man. You're too big to be a mouse. I reckon you're a rat.
That's logical.
Answer me one question. Do you love her?
Well...
Because if I thought you didn't, I tie you up in this bag and drop you in the river. Are you serious about it?
Yes, I'm serious.
Do you worship the grass she walks on, like I do? You better say yes.
Yes, yes, yes!
Hell, you do.
Yes.
Would you give everything you had in the world for her? That's what I did. See this bag? Full of presents. It cost me $50. All I had in the world.
And if you had that $50 cash...
I'd have Ada Annie. You'd lose her.
Yes. I'd lose her. Let's see what you got in here. Might want to buy something, huh?
What would you want to buy?
I'm a peddler, ain't I? I buy, I sell. Maybe pay you real money. Maybe as much as, a lot, huh? Oh, what a beautiful hot water bag. It looks French. Must have cost plenty. I give you
$8. $8? That wouldn't be honest.
All right, I said I will give you $8 and I will. Oh, what a cracker, Jay.
Get your hands off that. That was supposed to be for a wedding night.
It don't fit you so good. I give you $22.
That's much.
All right, $22.50, not a cent more. What a beautiful ankle brace.
That was supposed to be for her to wear.
I didn't hardly think it was for you. Mighty dainty. I give you $15. Let's see. 8 and 22 is 30, plus 15 is 45, plus 50 cents is 45.50.
45.50.
Yeah.
Well, that's all. Want to buy anything else?
Might.
Did you ever see one of these?
Oh. What would you do with a thing like that? You got it in for somebody?
Well, how do you mean? It's just some funny pictures.
Is that all you think it is? Well, it's more than...
Where's everybody? Where's Aunt Ellen?
They're on the other side of the house, Lori. Lori, where'd you run to? So how much will you give me for this thing, anyway?
I don't carry things like that. Besides, I don't think you know what it is.
I sure do. It's just a girl with some pink tights. Hey, what do you two see, Lori? Yeah, she went on the other side of the house, Judd.
What's
going on?
Oh, Judd,
Here is one of them things you call the little wonder.
Oh. How much?
$3.50.
A lot of money. Got an idea it might be worth it.
Let's see. $3.50 from him, and $45.50 from you. That's $50, ain't it?
No, $1 short.
Darn it, must have figured wrong. How much did you give me for the rest of the stuff in the bag?
$1.
Done. Now I got $50, ain't I? Know what that means? It means I'm gonna buy it any back from you.
You would not do a thing like that to me.
Sure would. When I tell her Pa who I got most of the money off of, they'll think twice about who's smart. Who's dumb.
Say, young fellow, you certainly bumped me.
Now, here we are. Here's the last two hampers. Who's the heir? I ain't got no ID.
The little one's mine, and the one next to us, Lori's.
Well, there goes that surprise. Now, what am I bid for 8 Annie Camper here?
2 beds. 4.
How about 6? You slim? What's the matter? Ain't nobody hungry no more? How about you, peddler man? 6 bits?
No.
Come on.
6 beats.
Good. 6 bits. Now, that's not quite enough for the kind of lunch Ado Annie can fix. How about, let's hear a dollar. How about you, Mikey? You won her last year.
Yeah, that's right. Ado Annie, you got that same sweet potato pie like last year?
You bet!
Same old sweet potato pie, Mike. What do you say?
I say gave me a 3-day bellyache.
Well, never mind about that. Now, do I hear any bid?
Mine's the last bid. I got her for 6 bits.
And a dollar.
90 cents!
Oh, 90 cents? We got a bid for 90 cents. We're getting rich. Another desk for the schoolhouse. Do I hear any more? Let's hear some more here.
You hear $50.
$50? Why, ain't nobody ever bid $50 for lunch. Nobody ever bid 10.
He ain't got $50. I sure do. And if you're a man of honor, you gotta say it ain't belongs to me.
Where's your money?
It's right here in my hand.
That ain't yours. You just bid it. Belongs to the schoolhouse. I gotta say, the peddler still gets my daughter's hand.
Wait a minute, that ain't fair!
Going for $50. Go in.
$51.
You crazy?
$50. Wait a minute. If I don't bid no more, I get to keep this, right?
You sure do.
And I got $50. This is mine.
You feeble-minded shakepoke.
Going for $51.
And what do you get for your $51?
A 3-day bellyache.
I know we got my niece's hamper here. Looked inside a while back and it sure looks mighty tasty. What am I bid, gents?
Got 2 bits.
2 4 bits. Bits.
4 bits. Glenn, 6?
Dollar.
Dollar. Do I hear 2?
Dollar and a quarter.
Do I hear any more?
$2.
$2.
$2.50.
$3.
$3.
And 2 bits.
$2 and 2 bits.
$3 and 4 bits.
$3 and 4 bits.
$3. $4.
What? How much?
$4.
$4. All right. $4.
And 2 bits.
$4 and 2 bits. We got a bid for $4 and 2 bits. Now, from Chud Fry, are y'all going to let him have it for that?
Four and a half.
Going for four and a half.
$4.75.
Well, that's not near enough. In here, we ain't got the schoolhouse built yet. We still need a chimney.
$5.
$5. Going for $5.
$5 and 2 bits.
$5 and 2 bits. Why? That's not near enough for cold chocolate stuffing and lemon meringue pie.
$6.
$6. Going for
$6 and 2 bits.
My, you're stubborn, Judd. Mr. Carden's a lot richer than you, and I know he likes lemon custard with raspberry sauce. Am I going to hear any more?
No, they all dropped out. Can't you see?
You got enough, ain't Eller?
Let's get on with it. Come on.
Here's the money.
Now, you just wait a minute. I ain't said go and go and gone yet.
Sit.
Going for $6.02. The jug fry. Going.
What we'll get, Lori?
Jug fry.
And for how much?
6¼.
I don't figure that's quite enough, do you?
More than you got.
Got a saddle here costing $30.
Can't bid saddle. It's got to be cash.
Surely a $30 saddle must be worth something to somebody.
I'll give you 10. Don't be a fool, boy. Here, you'll live without a saddle.
Got cash?
Right here in my pocket.
Don't let's waste time. How you going?
Higher than you, no matter what.
Well, Aunt Eller, I bet all this $10 that Tom just gave me.
Go for $10,
Tom. $10.02.
Curly.
You boys know my horse. Done. She's a kind of good horse. Gentle. Well broke.
Don't trust on Curly. It ain't worth it.
I'll give you $25 for her.
All sale done to you. That makes the bid, $35, Aunt Eller.
Going for $35. Go in.
Hold on. Hold on. You ain't finished bidding yet. You put everything you got in the world, didn't you? Can't bid the clothes off your back because they ain't worth nothing. Can't bid your gun because you're going to need it. Yes, sir. You're going to need that bad. So, Aunt Eller, I'm just as reckless as Curly McLean, I guess. Just as good as getting what I want. Gonna bid all I got in the world. All I saved for 2 years doing farm work. Offer Lori. Here it is, $42.31.
Yeah. Anybody want to buy a gun? Worth a lot of money. Bought a brand new last Thanksgiving.
Please, don't sell your gun.
Sold. That brings the bid to $53, Aunt Eller. Anybody going any higher?
Going, God, for $53. Well, ain't anybody going to cheer or nothing?
Yeah. That's the idea. Farmer and Cowman should be friends. You lost the bid, but the bidding was fair. Come on, Cowman. Shake the farmer's hand.
Sure, I'll shake hands. My feelings, Curly.
That's better.
Say, Curly, I want to show you something. Thanks, Lori.
Thank you, Tom.
Thank you, sir. You see one of these?
Just what is that?
It's something special. Just put it up to your eye like this, see?
Curly! What you doing?
Doing? Nothing much. You want to squeal at a man like that for scare the liver and lights out of a feller.
Well, now, you just put that dirty French pictures away and dance with me. You brought me to this here social.
All right, then, you crazy old woman. I'll dance with you. I'll dance you all over the meadow you want.
Play that banjo.
I got the $50 cash. You can just name the date.
August 15th.
Why August 15th?
That was the first day I was kissed.
Was it? Well, I didn't remember that.
You wasn't there.
Now listen, Ado Annie. We gotta have a serious talk. Now that you got yourself engaged to me, you gotta stop having fun. I mean with other fellas. You'll have to be a little more standoffish. When members offer you a buggy ride,
I'll give an imitation of a crawfish and dig myself a hole where I can hide.
I heard how you was kicking up some capers when I was off in Kansas City, Mo. I hear some things you couldn't print in papers from fellers who've been talking like they know.
But I only did the kind of things I orta, sorta. To you I was as faithful as can be. For me, destroyed from the way I lost my bloomers.
What?
Bloomers! A lot of
the whole thing don't sound very good to me.
Well, you see,
I go and sold my last wild oat. I cut out all shenanigans. I save my money, don't gamble or drink in a back room down in Flanagan's. Give up lots of other things that a gentleman never mentions. Before I give up any more, I want to know your intentions. With me, it's all or nothing. Is it all or nothing with you? It can't be in between. It can't be now and then. No half-and-half romance we do. I'm a one-woman man, won't love and tie, all complete with slippers and pop. Dig me like I am or leave me be. If you can't give me all, give me nothing. And nothing's what you'll get from me.
Not even something.
Nothing's what you'll get from me.
It can't be in between. It can't be now and then.
No half and half romance will do.
Would you build me a house? Cute and clean and pretty and bright.
Big enough for two, but not for three.
Supposing that we should have a third one.
But he'd better look a lot like me.
Just get an image.
He'd better look a lot like me. Hi, ladies. Get on your legs there. Oh, yeah. Hey, that Persian!
Shaved 2 days. You asked me if I had a fever. You put your hand on my forehead to check.
I remember.
Do you? I shall remember as much as me. Remember everything you ever done, every word you ever said. Can't think of nothing else. See? See how it is? I ain't good enough for you, am I? I'm a hired hand. Got dirt on my hands. Things locked. Fit to touch you. You're so much better. Yeah, we'll see who's better, Miss Laura. And then you'll wish you wasn't so free in the air. You're such a fine lady.
You make a threat to me. Are you standing there trying to tell me if I don't lie slobbering me like a hog by it? You're gonna do something about it? You're nothing but a mangy dog! And somebody ought to shoot you! You think so much about being a hired hand. I'll tell you something that'll rest your brain, Mr. Judd. You ain't a hired hand for me no more! You can just pack up your desk and scoot! Oh, I even got better ideas than that. You ain't set foot on the place again, you hear me? I'll send your stuff anywhere you like. She was so much set foot inside the pasture gate, why, well, I'll stick the dogs on you!
Said you say. Told you how it was. Can't help it. Can't never rest. You wouldn't listen!
It's just me, Lori. Hey, have you seen Aunt Annie? She ran off again.
Oh, Will, could you do something for me? Go and find Curly and tell him I'm here. Hey, you seem awful bad. I gotta see him.
Why don't you turn around and look at him, you crazy woman?
Oh, Curly.
Now that you found yours, I gotta go lump mine.
Well, what on earth could be ailing the Belle and Claremore? What? Well, I don't you ain't crying.
Curly, I'm afraid. Afraid of my life.
Jumping toadstools.
Oh, I don't know what to do.
Why, it's all right.
I'm crying, I can't help it.
Cry your eyes out. Lori.
I don't know what to do. I really don't.
Here, let me show you. My goodness. That's about all a man can take in public. Go away from me, you.
Oh, don't you like me no more, Curly?
Like you? My God, get away from me. I said plumb away from me.
Curly, you're sitting on the stove!
What? Well, it's as cold as a hunk of ice.
I wish you burn a hole in your pan.
Do ya?
You hear me?
Well, looky here. You stand over there where you were, and I'll sit right here and you tell me what it was you wanted with me.
Well, your judge was here. And you scared me. It's crazy. He started talking wild and he threatened me so. So I fired him. I wish I hadn't. There's no telling what he'll do now.
We fired him? That's all there is to it then. Tomorrow I'll get you a new hired hand. Stay in the place myself tonight if you're nervous about that hound dog.
Aren't you worrying about it, Earl?
Well, while I'm thinking about it, how about marrying me? Oh,
gracious. Well, what do I want to marry you for?
Maybe think of some reason why you might.
Can't think of none right now, hardly.
Lori, please, ma'am, marry me. I just don't know what I'm gonna do if you don't.
Curly, of
course I'll marry you. I'll be the happiest man alive as soon as we get married. I got to learn to be a farmer, I can see that. Well, stop thinking about throwing the rope and starting to get my hands blistered in a new sort of way. Changing right and left. Buy up mowing machines to cut down the prairie. Shoe your horses and drag the plows onto the sidewalk. They're gonna make a state out of this here territory. They're gonna put it in the Union. Countries are changing. They got to change with it. Bring up a pair of boys. You stop. Keep up the way things are going around this here crazy country. Well, now I got you to help me. I'll amount to something yet. I remember the first time I ever seen you. It was at the fair, riding that gray filly of blue stars, and I said to someone, who's that skinny little thing with her bang hanging down on her forehead?
Yeah, I remember you was my trunks that day.
That's right.
One of them throwed you.
Yes. Well, it did not throw me.
I guess you jumped off then.
Well, sure I jumped off.
Yeah, you sure did.
Hey, if there's anybody out around this yard who can hear my voice, I want you to know that Lori Williams is my girl.
Curly.
She's went and got me to ask her to marry me.
Then I'll hear you all the way to Contusey.
Well, just let them then. Let people say we're in love. Who cares what happens now?
Let people say we're Christ came from above.
You like nothing ever loved nobody.
Yes, Sammy Hacker.
A man who will stick to you for the rest of your years. That is the man for you, Will Parker.
Oh, yeah. Well, I like Will a lot.
Oh, he's a fine fellow. Strong like an ox. Young and handsome.
I love him all right, I guess.
Oh, of course you do. And you love those clear blue eyes of his and the way his mouth wrinkles up when he smiles.
Do you love him too?
I love him because he will make my Adu Annie happy. Goodbye, my baby. I'd show you how we say goodbye in Persia. Huh?
That was goodbye?
We have an old song in Persia. It goes, one goodbye is never enough. I am so glad you are going to marry such a wonderful man as this Will Parker. You deserve a fine man, and you got one.
Hello, Will. Allie Hacker was saying goodbye.
Oh, Will, I want to say goodbye to you, too.
No, no, you don't. I just saw the last one.
What a happy couple. You be good to her, Will. You be good to him, too. You don't mind a friend of the family now, huh?
I thought you said you was going now.
Yes, I must. Back to the open road, the lonely gypsy. I show you how we say goodbye in my country, huh? Friend of the family, huh? Ah, Persian goodbye! Oh, lucky fellow! I wish it was me she was marrying instead of you!
Doesn't make no difference, hardly.
Back to the open road, the lonely gypsy! One goodbye is never enough!
You ain't gonna think about that old peddler man again, are ya?
Of course not! Never think of no one unless he's with me!
Well, I'm never leaving your side.
Well, even if you don't, even if you never go away on a trip or nothing, can ya? Once in a while, give me one of them Persian goodbyes.
Persian goodbye? That ain't nothing compared to an Oklahoma hello.
Oh! Hello, Will!
Back to the bar with us getting drunk. Never seen you stay so sober at a wedding party.
Scared. Been scared all night that Judd Fry come and go for Curly.
Well, Judd Fry's been out of territory for 3 weeks.
He's back. Seen him at Claremore's last night, drunk as a lord.
Come on, let's have 3 cheers for the happy couple. Hip hip!
Hooray!
Hip hip!
Hooray!
Hip hip!
Hooray!
Preacher said that about you taking us here, woman.
Well, I was scared you wouldn't say it.
Well, I was ready back out on it. They couldn't pick a better time to start in life.
It ain't too early and it ain't too late.
Starting as a farmer with a brand new wife.
Soon be living in a brand new state.
Brand new state. Gonna treat your grave.
Potatoes,
pasture for the cattle,
spinach and tomatoes,
flowers on the prairie with
a broom to swing a rope.
Smells sweet when the wind comes right behind the rain. Oh, I hope every night my honey lamb and I sit alone and talk and watch a hawk making lazy circles in the sky. We know we belong to the land, and the land we belong to is grand. So when we say,
yeah,
fire, fire, oh yeah,
should count like golden wedding.
But if you married her, you must have wanted to.
Sure I wanted to. I wanted to marry her when I saw the moonlight shining down the barrel of her father's shotgun. I thought it would be much better to be alive. Now I ain't so sure.
That ain't gonna drive around the bush no more. I decided I'm gonna settle down the bush and let you run pop the stuff. Look, Will!
Mighty glad to hear that, peddler man. Think I already kissed the bride. Friend of the family, remember? Hey, Gertie, you ever have an Oklahoma hello?
You're going.
I'm gonna stop Aiden from killing your wife.
You mind your own business.
first. I want to kiss the bride.
Get away from some of you. Let me take a look at it.
I was saying,
I didn't go to.
It can't be like that to happen to us.
You can't do nothing for him here. Let's get him to a doctor, but I don't know.
Here, somebody carry him over to my rig. I'll drive him over to Dr. Tyler's.
Quick now.
I'm afraid it's already too late.
I have to go see if there's anything to be done for him. Take care of him.
Easy now. Watch your step, fellas.
Honey, maybe you and right, Curly shouldn't up. Leave tonight.
Why did this have to happen when everything was so fine?
Don't let your mind dwell on it.
I can't forget, I tell you, I never will.
If you can't forget, that's all right. These things happen in life. Poor and hungry and sick and old and afeard to die. That's life from cradle to grave. But you can manage. You can do it. There is a way. You gotta be hardy. You can't deserve the fine and tender things in life. Listen, you're tough.
I wish it was the way you were, you know.
Oh, fiddlesticks. Old and mean like me. I wouldn't hire me to be the way I am.
I don't know what I'd do without you. You're such a crazy.
Sure, you're born. You can come.
Well, they're taking Judd over to Dave Tyler's till morning.
Is he alive?
Laura, honey. Well, poor Elam here, he's a federal marshal, you know. He says I ought to give myself up. Tonight, he says.
Tonight?
But your train leaves from Claremore in 20 minutes.
The best thing is for Curly to go over his own accord and tell the judge.
Well, Andrew, you're a judge, ain't you?
Yes, but I don't
know. Tell him now and get it over with.
That wouldn't be proper. You've got to do it in court.
Well, let's do it right here and say we did it in court.
You can't do that. That's breaking the law.
Oh, we're not going to break the law. We're just going to bend it a little. Now, come on, Andrew. We ain't got all night. Let's get on with it here.
Andrew, I got to protest.
Shut up. We can get the boy a fair trial without locking him up on his wedding night.
That's right.
Okay, here's the long and the short of it. What's your plea? That means, why'd you do it?
Well, why'd I do it? Well, because he'd been pestering Lori, and I always said that someday I'd...
Just a minute. Don't let your tongue wobble around in your head like that. Listen to my question. What happened tonight did you kill him?
Well, he come at me with a knife, and then
and you had to defend yourself, right?
Of course. And furthermore...
Never mind the furthermore. The plea is self-defense. Anybody here see this happen?
Yeah, we did.
I feel funny about this. Real funny.
You're gonna feel a lot funnier when I tell your wife you've been carrying on with another woman.
I ain't carrying on with no one.
Well, maybe not, but you sure gonna feel funny when I tell your wife there.
The cows earn it now. You laugh all you want, but as federal marshal.
Oh, shut up about being a marshal. We ain't gonna let you send the boy to jail on his wedding
night.
We just ain't gonna let you. So shut up. Come on, fellas. Let's take them over to their training, Curly, sir. And we'll be the horses.
Yeah.
Wait a minute. I ain't said the verdict.
Well, the verdict's not guilty, ain't it?
Of course, but I gotta
well,
say it.
Well, say it, Andrew.
Not guilty.
Court adjourned.
Well, there's a NATO. Eddie, where you been?
Bill and me had a misunderstanding, but he explained it fine.
Boom, boom, boom.